Hello, my name is Radek, and I would like to present you a new feature inside Scada-LTS, the PLC alarms. Let's see how it looks like.
Basic configuration is already provided to the application, but in our scenario, specific user group should receive notifications using email or SMS messages when specific alarm is raised. In the beginning, we have to define a recipient list where our teammates will be assigned on. To do that, we should navigate to the new Scada-LTS user interface and open the recipient list page. Then we can create a new recipient list by clicking on the green plus button. Now in this dialog box, we set up the name of the list. For example, I will use the name day shift. Next, we have to add recipient entries. To do that, we can click on the Add User Recipients button in the Entry section. From the Select box, we choose Administrator Account to be notified about all alarm events, and then we add the first operator account. When the smoke alarm occurs, we should be immediately informed about that situation. So we will configure an additional entry that will contain the phone number. To add a phone number to a recipient list, I should click on the Add Phone Number button and fill up the form with valid form format. When everything is okay, I can apply changes. We have to configure an additional recipient list with the second theme. To do that, we should repeat the previous steps. This recipient list will be called Night Shift. Now, it is not necessary to inform users about changes immediately, but still we want to inform the staff about the AO condition. We can add an email address that is not related to any user. To do that, we can just click on the Other Email Recipient button. Now we have to provide the correct email address and apply changes. We finished our recipient list configuration. Now it's time to bind alarm data points with specific recipient list. To do that, we have to move to the alarm notifications page. Here we can see in the top right corner two selects with recipient list. We have to choose both of our list to see available alarm points. When the data source and these points has been loaded, we can configure our notification system. The most important in our case is the city center smoke AL alarm point. So when the event takes place, we should be informed immediately via SMS message. To do that, we just click phone icon on the right side. We can see configurations for each recipient list. The first one is related to the day shift recipient list, and the second one is related to night shift. For the warning point, we set up just the email notification. In our scenario, we gather the dust measurements also from the devices located in Tarno City. Our operators should be informed about any alarm that is active there. So we configure that to send the email and SMS notification. Our configuration is done. Now we have to just save it and check that everything is working properly. To do that, we move to the data point list. We find the city center smoke ST warning data point. Then, at the data point details page, we change the alarm value from 0, which means inactive, to 1, which means that alarm is enabled and active. Okay, let's check our mail server. As you can see, I received email with the smoke level warning. In this application, I can see all the recipients that will receive that message. We can see that our operators and administrator user. Now it's time to validate the SMS notification channel. To see the SMS event, we have to raise the alarm state inside the City Center's smoke AL alarm data point. Now in our SMTP server, we can notice the phone numbers with the SMS domain address. Yes, SMS messages can be sent from the Scada-LTS, but to do that, we have to configure an external SMS gateway that will convert this message into plain text SMS. As you can see, this configuration is very easy. These settings has been located on the dedicated page with an eye-catching layout. Administrators can easily find and modify notification configuration. But what about the second side? Let's check. I will try to find the Tarnow data source in the list. Oh, I've got it. So let's change the alarm state from 0 to 1 and then check the mailing server. Nice! We can see every email and SMS message from the Tarnow data source. Even on the watch list, we can see the alarm events. We can see them because this notification mechanism is built on the existing event handler service. This service has been improved and extended to process also SMS content. You can see the raw configuration if you open the event handlers page. Each alarm point has its own event detector that waits for the point change. When event detector is activated, the message is provided to a specific event handler that processes that message into the final result. As you can see, each event handler keeps the recipient list configuration. In the end, I would like to present how to configure that email and SMS server mechanism. To do that, we should open the system settings page and move to the email settings section. There, we have to provide the valid SMTP server configuration. Then we have to move to the SMS domain section and type the SMS gateway server address. Remember to save the settings and enjoy new notification feature in your Scada-LTS.